for your life. Take a while for you to work about.
From tomorrow, you'll be shuffling.
I love you too, darling.
Don't let yourself.
No, I won't be disappointed.
Should I be done a video piece? Be able to complete it. Hello. Ele ta ti bere mo pare roko Jesu. No say me.
No, no, can't be specific.
I love you too, mama. I love you deeply.
It's called Eklan, right?
Yes, Eklan.
Hiya love, Whitney Houston and Kigo, one of my all-time favorites. You're tuning to Breakfast in Bed here on Smooth 98.1. Love music, love life. My name is Oluwaseun Olusegun, and we are now in the Soul Food Conversation segment. You're welcome to join us. The number to send your WhatsApp messages to, your thoughts, your messages, your questions, something you want to clarify, will always be the same, 0809-444-0981. If you want to see what's going on in the studio, please do that. Go to our YouTube channel, Smooth 92 FM Lagos is what you're searching for on YouTube. And if you want to call into the show, 01-448-9981. Ladies and gentlemen, please meet my guest. Her name is Mrs. Victoria Olawumi, and she's an Eklan Certified Speech and Language Therapist with over 15 years of professional experience that she gained across various fields of special needs, including speech and language therapy, behavioral therapy, and of course, other areas of occupational therapy. She has worked as a speech therapist and special needs consultant at various schools and centers, and that includes Meadow Hall School, Green Spring School, Patrick Speech and Language Center, Mater Dei Schools, and FOS Creative. She is a lover of children, all children, and she has hers too. And she's also the founder and managing director of the V's Place, a language and speech center. So ladies and gentlemen, men and women, please make welcome Mrs. Victoria Olawumi.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning. Thank you so much for joining me this morning. I really do appreciate it. I mean, taking your time to be here in the studio. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody.
Yeah, it's a pleasure. And yeah, so again, if you want to join the conversation, what you can do is send your messages to 0809-444-0981. I have mentioned stammering many times today, and no, I didn't stutter. Now, let us define what stammering is, not just in terms of the dictionary definition, now in terms of the professional aspect. How do you define stammering?
So let's take it from here. Stammering is a speech disorder that affects the flow of speech, and then that's I mean fluency. I mean it affects the oral cords when you're making sounds. So when it just takes you off balance. So stammering can be as an effect of brain injury. It can also be an effect of brain disorder. So it depends on where, if it's an onset, or maybe that's overly, or maybe it's a developmental stage. So stammering, it comes, it's all encompassing. So you can just, for a layman, I would just only say to you that stammering is a speech and language disorder, which affects your speech and your chords when you're making, it gives you broken speech.
Now, you mentioned something while you were explaining it. So what actually determines the severity of stammering? Somebody who ordinarily, because we have people who ordinarily do not stammer. They stammer when they get into some conditions, or maybe people who stammer normally, they just get into some situations and it just get worse. What determines the severity of stammering?
Now, a speech and language pathologist will determine that. So what do they do? They test the levels of the consonant and the vowels fluency. So when you know that you have a condition, you're going for a test. So they go ahead to test if there's an oral issue. So the pitch at the length. So they'll know if you're going through the then before you say, you start your words. So that's the severity. So that would be the levels. Okay. Then you know that I spoke about developmental. So it's often in children. That's so the children, then the onset is the one that happens when you have Parkinson's disorder, stroke, and all that. That's when it's like for acquired. But when they, you know, and also when you say that they some people go into stammering when they talk, different. You know, you have types of stammering. So let's should I dive into that?
Yes, please. Types of stammering. Let's talk about that.
You know, I spoke about developmental is in children, and I go on to say that now it can be neurogenic. So neurogenic, it's the stammering that affects your nerves and the muscles.
Okay.
Yeah. So, and also the other one. So, if we're talking about developmental level neuro, then we're talking about psychogenic one is the one that affects your reasoning and your thinking. So you say that that's when you stammer. So you're trying to think of the words. You're trying to go. Then go. You start going. Okay. What's then you say it. So if let me give an example of when you're making psychogenic stammering. You go. I want to start the meeting. So it's like you're thinking. So it affects the part of the brain that where you think. So that we're trying to bring out ideas.
So it's like you can think and talk at the same time?
Yes. So oftentimes we advise that if in therapy, you would think about what you want to say before you have the conversation. So it can't do spontaneous. You can't just flow like other people, so-called other people, typical people do. So you're taught to put the words in your head, then you say it. I think I shouldn't go too much because they pay for this. They pay for this.
Okay. But at least we're just trying to, because a lot of people have believed different things about stammering, and we're just trying to clear that up. All right, so the developmental, I'm very interested in that one. It has to do with the one in children.
Children, yes. So if, you know, when you go for a test that, okay, my child stammers, then they will ask, when did your child start stammering? So it will link us to if it's a developmental stammering. Then it will link us to if it's acquired. You know, the kids can actually copy their friends and they would start stammering.
What?
Yeah. I had a friend a few years ago. She called me and she was like, hurry, we're in trouble. I said, are you okay? She said, I'm not okay. My daughter is stammering. And I said, but I said, okay, I think we need to. She wasn't born that way. So she knew that it was copied. So that could be, you know, pair. If I like someone that stammer, so I want to speak like them. So it's a good one because they want to feel cool with it. Then they're going to,
What if they're making fun of the person?
Yeah. So that's the when they have that. Now, you know, that's when people stammer.
Yeah.
When I say that you need to go for tests, you would also need to go for counseling.
Okay.
Yeah, because there's social communication issues here. A lot of people make fun and just of people that stammer. Then you get to have that idea that you are not enough for the world.
Yeah.
So that's when, so speech wouldn't only work for you. I would need to send you to a behavioral therapist or to do a cognitive, that we call it CBT, cognitive behavioral therapy.
Yeah.
So that you can go through that moment where you have conversation, then you nip it down to what really happened that it got to you, that you have psychological issues. So that's a lot. Because see, a lot of people that stammer often develop depression.
Depression. Not just estimation, no, it's depression.
Depression. Because, you know, if you don't, you know, that's why I say that early intervention is key. So if I notice that my child is stammering at, let's say, 3, I take it. You can walk and this child will stop. And the child will now, what do we say that we, and I'm not saying that you, it's magic. Now, it's managing stammering. You're teaching the child how to talk. So you know that it's a part of your brain that you need to so, you know, if you use electronic device, when you teach them how to stop stammering, they listen and you try to listen so that I can correct and tell you what to say and how to say it. Those are the, when after the child is in diagnosis, you can't just jump into that. But then they are in therapy, they are using CBT, they are using electronic devices. So you would, those are the process of trying to come out of stammering.
Okay.
Then, and if I stammer, I can sit like you, but I cannot bend while talking.
Okay, you know what? We need to take a quick break so that we can break all of that down into bits and pieces for people to understand and maybe ask their questions. You're listening to Smooth 98.1.
One XBet makes betting easier with their app for both Android and iPhone users.
Very easy.
Playing virtuals and betting with ease and speed has made it more fun to play on the One XBet app. Download the OneXBet app on our website, onexbet.ng, and use the promo code NG21 if you're creating your account for the first time. OneXBet.
Coming back, you know. Yeah.
Okay,
LinkedIn.
What's up?
Seems refreshing. That's what you get whenever you stay tuned to us and, of course, the good information. Right now, you're tuning to Breakfast in Bed on Smooth 98.1. Love music, love life. My guest is Olawumi Victoria, and she's a speech therapist. We're talking about stammering, and she has confused me further. Now let us break it down. You were talking about psychogenic, you were talking about developmental and other things that it presents with. I want to ask, because the psychogenic, you said they cannot think and talk at the same time. Some people have said that stammering impacts your intellectual capacity. Is that true?
Should I use N-O, capital letter N-O, the answer is no.
Okay.
If you stammer, it doesn't affect your IQ. Mm. It has only affected the path where you process your speech and language, your communication, where you, the oral path.
Mm.
So it's for you to take it in that it hasn't affected you from studying. It can only, now, why would they say it affects a child and the child has an IQ issue? Now, it might be that the child has been affected through school-based.
Mm.
Now, they stammer in class, they can't answer questions.
Mm.
And they can't tell the teacher that they don't understand. Then they lose important foundational information.
Oh.
Yeah, so that's why they say that, okay, maybe it's not intelligent. No, it is very intelligent, but the people around, the environmental issues that he or she had not made it work.
Mm.
So you're going to a level that you want to feel what other people feel. They communicate, they socialize in class, you cannot. So, and now if you want to, they want to test their oral or verbal intelligence.
Mm.
You ask a child a question, the child is stammers, and you're like, you're impatient. You still go like, can you? Then you don't know that the child cannot move on, then there's an impending issue there. Then they shut down. They stop talking to you. Mm. So they know that they often are so happy when you are very patient, when you allow them talk. So those are means that, okay, the means which tells you that when someone is stammering, help them complete their sentence. No, that's rude and very, 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 very
condescending.
Yeah, that's the word. So if I'm talking, I want to complete a sentence. Just, okay, I'll give an example. So I'll finish this sentence and I'll try to stammer, then try and help me. Then you see how I want to see how it feels. So that the world needs to understand that we have feelings too. So I'll go this way. Speech disorder is technically.
Well,
that's the way it is. So there might be a word, there might be a letter that, so you know, it's when they come for therapy, we tell them that we'll monitor. So the parents have the notebook of, they call it case study, of when the point at which they stammer, they stutter. So they, it might be an event, it might be a word, it might be a vowel, it might be a consonant. Is that, so it's so simple to conquer the issues if you know what to do. So I'll tell you to write it down. Anytime it happens, that's an onside. It keeps happening. So you write that word down, you write that syllable down. So if it is if it is, you want to say ah, then you say write it out. So we know when to, like, what to do and how to do it. So so it's easy to work with when you have that details of when it has happened and when it is still happening. So it's that.
Wow, I didn't know that we had so many elements in stammering. I just thought it's something that you can, because a number of people say, oh, whenever you're stammering, try to go easy whenever, or slow down your rate of speech whenever you're trying to talk. But apparently, I'm not sure that's the answer. Yeah, I'm laughing.
You know why I'm laughing?
Yeah.
They often copy the breathing techniques. Now, breathing techniques, it can only be used as when you have been taught what to do.
Okay.
So I tell you to breathe in speech therapy. You want to say a word, you breathe. Put the word in your head, put the sentence in your head. If it's thought that you want to say, put thought in your head, then you say it, then you don't stammer. So it's not take it easy when you go. Then the person will be anxious, anxiety will set in, and they will stammer more. Wow. So when you go, like, keep it calm, keep it easy. Is it easy to keep it easy when you have a nerve and a muscle that is pulling down and blocking the flow of speech? It's not that easy. So it's I would want to us to often welcome and say, take your time and count. So I often count. So if I'm working with a child and I know that word is difficult, I will ask a question and I'm expected to count 1 to 20, not by
saying it out.
Yeah. So I go. So there's no eye contact that says, please, I'm busy, you have to move. So well, that's when at home they advise parents to take it easy with any child that stammer. So because they say, like, your brother is in stammering, will you be fast? I don't know where you got this from. Will you just be fast, trust me. So it does it help the child? No, it doesn't help the child. It helps the child, it get worse. Now the developmental stammering that isn't handled well will get to severe level. So okay. Now why do they say that girls often are more, they come out easy? Now they come up.
Okay, go ahead.
Now, so they do, now get often, when girls are taught to do stuff, they believe that the boys are the now girls come out of stammering easy when they are taught. It's just the genetic test that girls learn faster than the boys.
Yeah.
Yes. So it's a test, it's a research. That the girls are, so they feel that when a girl stammer, when you teach them, they learn faster. That's where the thing comes from, that the girls, you don't see a lot of girls stammering, but the men stutter more. And as teenagers, so when I work with teenagers, you know, teenagers are in a level where they have pair issues when they stammer. So if you have a teenager at home, I would say that introduce speech therapy, because it would affect the child when they go into the iron institution, because they get a lot of side talks. People don't want to have communications, people don't want to have discussions because they're wasting time. Just imagine them in a group discussion and they go, they stammer. So if you don't nip it in the bud now, as a baby, a child, like a toddler that stammers, it will come out and go into and out, grow into adults.
Okay.
But over time, it's getting reduced because people were aware of what's going on.
Yeah.
So everybody knows that, oh, I can go in for a test. I can go in to test if it's severe, if it's mild, if it's moderate, so I can test and see. So
that's interesting. Very, very interesting. Now, you've talked about getting help and telling the parents to go seek help with the speech therapy. In Nigeria, from your practice, how receptive are parents as touching speech therapy? How often was the health-seeking behavior of parents as touching taking them to rehabilitation centers, speech therapy centers, and all of that? Because I wouldn't know if it's something that is commonly accepted or if people are enlightened enough to know that not everything will be treated or dealt with in the hospital.
You know, the good thing now is that hospitals are aware, so they refer.
Great.
We have hospitals that refer to our center. So immediately, I know Lasto to refers, Lute will refer and say, oh, you need to see. So when they get the test done and they see there's a problem, they quickly get them referred. Before, I'm talking about early 90s, we were not receptive. Parents will say that, my cousin used to stammer and he stopped stammering.
Do people just stop stammering?
No.
Okay.
You have to work. So you don't know if they've been doing something or if the child has been taught to go through it. Because I have clients that when they were younger, they were stammering. Then later, the mother said, I taught him how to stop. I said, how did you do that? I said, I read up online. I couldn't pay for a speech therapist. And you know, I was telling her, like, that was last year, that you just got lucky. She said, oh, don't worry, I'm a professional too.
Okay.
So that's a motherly thing. So you go and search and you need help. So the daughter was stammering. She went in search for help. She went on Google and she said she learned a lot. She said, oh, I can tell you about what you do, how to place your head, how to place your neck. I was like, so I was really, really amazed because if you don't know that I'm doing all that, they say, Dupe was stammering and she stopped stammering.
Mm.
So you don't know that I've done some other things to stop. Then, you know, why do stroke patients come for speech therapy? Because that's an acquired
stammer.
And yeah, so, and you know that it's not even acquired stammering, acquired speech disorder, because some of them lose their words.
Aphasia,
so they lose it. Then you need to teach them how to talk again. So,
all right, before then, you mentioned that there are some positions, sitting and standing positions, that a person who is stammering cannot be in or do if they want to talk. Tell me more about that.
You would need to sit up.
Okay.
So you can't be on your bed and you have phone conversation like everybody does.
Why? It's like I'm sitting on my words or what?
No! It's the connections. So you need to put the word and you think, then the muscle that is causing the blockage would work well. So you know it's a muscle. So if it's the neurogenic one, so it's the muscle that it's causing some blockage. So you would have to, and so you not collapse, so you need to sit up. So that's why you need to know what type.
Okay.
So because we won't say that the pegs were fitting. So I would ask and we'll go through some tests to know, okay, this is the issue here, that is the issue there. So then we'll put it the right perspective to make it work. Now some people will test all techniques and it will work for them. So now let me say that if you can slouch. So those are the free thing you can, okay, if your child is stammering, so I will tell you that try not to let them slouch. So they need to breathe. So what do you do? Breathing technique, breathe every morning. Teach your child how to breathe.
Okay, how do you breathe apart from the way we're breathing?
You want to talk.
Okay.
Now you've been told to breathe. Now when you breathe, it calms your nerves. So you go in, out. So you do 20 times. So it depends on the diagnosis and the categories. Then you learn to, you told you what to do. Okay, if, okay, you're supposed to use 10 breath, 10 in, 10, 20 out, so you know. So at that point, you know that if you're a comma, the words will get put together and you will make the speech slowly. Now, they are taught to speak slowly, but later taught to move up their speech. We need to. So I think, so you've gotten a lot of free tips this morning. So I think I would love to stop there.
Thank you very much for your generosity.
No.
Let's take the last break, and when we come back, we'll be rounding off this conversation on stammering. Do not go anywhere.
What's up?
This is hundreds of thousands of.
I did not know.
I had no idea it was this. I just thought, you know, stammering is, you just have to.
You know, when I said 30 minutes, I was laughing because it's a lot.
This is interesting.
It's a lot. Oh, nice. So we are. Have you sent the link?
Yes.
Your people are on your. On YouTube, you know, everywhere with all the emojis. See them. And
this
stuff.
This is middle whole staff.
I can see lovely.
See them.
The support
this is
lovely.
Yes. That's my husband.
Okay.
And you're like, that's I can.
What's the difference between stuttering and stammering? It's the same. Stammering is British English. Stuttering is American
you're good.
English.
You're good.
Yeah.
No, you know, I will tell you the misconception that happened before.
Okay.
That people would say that stammering is the when you have words issue. Okay.
Okay.
Class music.
Can you feel it? I totally can. Thank you for staying tuned to the conversation. This is Smooth 98.1. Love music, love life. Are you watching us on YouTube? You can quickly join the party before it ends. At Smooth 98.1 FM Lagos is the channel you're searching for on YouTube. And of course, you can send your WhatsApp messages to 0809-444-0981. I have the chance for one quick call. So if you're fast enough in the next 2 minutes, you can quickly dial the number 01-448-9981. I'll take this message that we're talking about before we came back on. It says, what is the difference between stuttering and stammering? And I was saying stammering basically is a British English for stuttering, while stuttering is the American English. But you said there was a misconception before now. Okay.
Yeah, before now, the people would say stammering is when you have blockage with a word. So you, and stuttering is when you have blockage with some consonants and vowels. So it's, so let me give an example. Before, okay, they would say stammering is where you go, pump. Then stuttering is when you say, you're saying, come. The
okay.
So
yeah,
that was a misconception, but it's just the British. And so
American
that's
English,
American.
Yeah, they're basically the same. So now you have that. All right, we cannot finish the whole conversation on stammering today, but at least it's been insightful. You have mentioned in between all of that how to deal with stammering, and you know, it is very specific, just like any other thing with health. It is very, very specific. Go to the therapist and they'll tell you, you know, with your unique conditions, they will diagnose and then tell you how best to achieve a good quality of life. But is there any other thing you want to add, general advice, tips?
Can we talk about myths and beliefs?
Yes, please. Just, yeah, because we're out of time. Just one or two.
When you stammer, you are not intelligent.
Yeah,
that's,
that one, yeah.
Please, let's cross that out. It is totally demeaning when you say someone is not intelligent because of their disorder. So stammering is like you have dyscalculia too. So it's not, it's that it's, you have issues. So it's a disability that's on there. So it's, it doesn't mean that because you have dyscalculia, you don't understand math, you're not intelligent. And also if people say that you need to rush words, that you would tell them to keep it easy, don't rush your words. So that means, and people also say that it's village people.
That's ridiculous. Nah, stammering is not village people, please.
So please, let's seek help.
Okay.
Help is key. If any intervention works, therapy works. Thank you for inviting us.
It's a pleasure. And yes, parents too, you should pay close attention to your kids and do not compare your kids, because you mentioned while you were explaining that stammering could actually lead to depression and not just self-esteem issues. It could, yes, set them up for bullying, which can also lead to depression. So pay attention to them. Don't compare them. Don't say, oh, your sister is more intelligent, smarter, and all of that. No, every child is unique and you should tend to them that way. And again, please do not, there was a very key one you mentioned, don't try to always complete people's sentences for them. You know the way people who are physically challenged do not like to be given some sort of unnecessarily fair advantage because of their disability. So that's the same way. You shouldn't try to always help somebody who's stammering to complete their statement. It just makes them feel less. So now that you know all of that, please do better. Remember, today is Make a Difference Day. Make a difference and be better. Thank you so much for being a part of the conversation. We'll be back again next week. Soul Food Conversation from 8 to 8:30. And of course, saying something about your health and wellness. Now, this YouTube stream will be up for you to just catch up on the conversation. And of course, share with somebody. Share it with somebody who has missed out on this conversation. And if you want to go back, you want to see some of the ways in which she demonstrated, yes, it's very important, it will be up there. Just search for Soul Food 981, what you need to know about stammering, because I care about you. I also will put the status, or rather put the link up on our WhatsApp status. If you're not a part of our WhatsApp status, go right now, send your message as a WhatsApp message, 0809-444-0981. I will take a break. You know, when I come back, it will be time for the kiddies, Curious Minds 840. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody. Go ahead and tell everybody.
I like this song.
Oh, you do? I'm gonna turn it up.
Yes, I am, yes, I am, yes, I am. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. I believe every lie that I ever told. Paid for every heart that I ever stole. I played my cards and I didn't fold. Well, it ain't that hard when you got sold.
Papa, I believe it.
Somewhere I heard that life is a test.
Thank you to everyone watching.